Baba Gbenro, Mama Gbenro, Gbenro himself, and then Mr. Martins. In this video, we'll take a look at the four people and how come the unity between them is not as strong as it should be, or is not as strong as a family unity should be. My name is Lydia and welcome back to Sahara Movies. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe for more videos and more updates. So from what we've been watching, we realize that it's like the family, they've done it like division of labor. So Baba Gbenro is showing more affection to Mr. Martins, whereas Mama Gbenro is showing more affection to Gbenro himself. And why should that be so? And every time Mama Gbenro is arguing with Baba Gbenro that Martins is not her son, you've done enough for him, why are you still going on and doing more things that he's not even appreciating? Whereas you have your own son, you don't even think about, you don't even call him, you don't, like, though you keep in touch, but at least the connection you have with Martins, can't you let the connection be stronger as the connection you have with Gbenro? And Mama Gbenro is like, you know, the devil finds a way to get in between people who are having like something like loggerheads. So the devil finds out that the family are not stable. They are not stable in terms, they are not stable psychologically, because Mama Gbenro is thinking more of Gbenro himself, and then Baba Gbenro is also concentrating on Mr. Martin. So it's like, this, the family is divided, so it's easily for the devil to strike. In the recent episode that Mama Gbenro had a dream and she called her husband to tell him about the dream, I was like, so there's still unity in the family, because if you don't think about someone, I don't think you have a dream about the person. Or if you don't pray for someone, I don't think a dream about the person's well-being will bother you. Yeah, so I think there's still unity, even though for right at the moment they have arguments, they have lots of misunderstandings and all that, but I think there's still unity. Yeah, now on the part that Gbenro betrayed his dad, Gbenro betrayed his family. You see, when Gbenro received a huge amount of money and bought a car for his parents, he sent them the gift with so much like with good intentions, with pleasure, with happiness, and with all that. He doesn't really know what's going on. So I think I wouldn't blame him so much, because he doesn't really know what's going on. And from the story, he only came to meet Mr. Martins in his house like twice, like just, and his connection with Mr. Martins is not as strong as his connection, it's not as strong as the connection his dad has with Mr. Martins. So he deliberately deciding to ignore his dad's advice is because he doesn't really know Martins. He doesn't really know Martins. According to the story, he only came to see Martins 7 years ago. And if you have a brother and you don't hear from him or anything, there's no way you're going to develop emotional attachment to him or him or her. Like if you have a sibling and you don't hear from them for so long, there's no way you're going to develop an emotional attachment for them. So that is Benro's side. I think that the reason he betrayed his parents is one, because they refused the present he gave them, and also because he doesn't really understand what's going on. You know, if Martins has been accused of rape, he doesn't really know Martins so well. All he knows is that his dad cares for Martins so much. And if my dad cares for someone so much, it doesn't mean he can't do something wrong. So Benro betraying his parents because he gave them a present, you know, that's pain. Like when you give someone a gift and then the person refuses it right in front of you, like it's going to be like very heartbreaking. And also because the vibe between he and Martins is not that strong. Yeah, if his dad wants to build a connection between Martins and Gbenro, he really needs to take his time. He really needs to make it slow. He really needs to make it one step at a time. Because it's like, as his wife said, he's fighting the battle alone. Nobody is fighting with him. His wife is not with him. His son is not with him. He's the only one defending Martins. And I understand it when he says that, if you don't want to fight with me, I'll stand with God. It's good. He's making a point, but at least you should get your family involved so that if the devil wants to strike, it becomes difficult because the unity between the family is unbreakable. Yeah. So now that Baba Gbenro is going to be hospitalized in the next episode, I'm hoping that they are going to share lots of apologies, remorse. They are going to get back on their feet. You know, sometimes there should be a downfall before you can get back on your feet. If there's no downfall, things will just scatter and scatter and scatter. So that's what I think about the Gbenro family. I think that Baba Gbenro is on track giving attention to Mr. Martins, but he should let his family be involved. He should let his family be involved. He cannot force anyone, but at least convince, like as his wife said, I'm beginning to understand that Mama Gbenro wants Baba Gbenro to show the same efforts that he shows to Martins to Gbenro. Like, that is what I think she wants to say. Yes, because the signs that she's been showing is just like she doesn't agree that Mr. Martins has taken like Baba Gbenro's heart so much whilst his own son is there somewhere. He doesn't really know what's happening to his son. So she expects Baba Gbenro to give the same attention to Gbenro himself. Yeah. So that's what I think about the Gbenro family. It's a good family. It's a family that can stand strong on the ground if they are united. You know this saying that if a broom is together, it becomes very difficult to break them. But if they are single, like, you can break them easily. If the family were that united, like, Baba Gbenro would have had an idea who his son is going to, like, I mean, he's going to defend or something. Because he would have discussed it with his dad before accepting the money, if the unity was that strong between the father and the son, or even the mother and the son. He would have discussed it with them before buying the car. He would have discussed it with them because, you know, when you are united, you know everyone's secret, you know everyone's circle, like, you know what's going on in each other's life. So I think that because they are partly dispersed, that's how come Gbenro accepted the offer that is almost costing him his dad's life. Yeah, so I'm praying that Gbenro will live to see the success of Mr. Martins, because he cannot fight in vain. He cannot just be going up and down and then eventually lose his life. Like, what's the point? So we are wishing strength for Gbenro that he should survive the battle. He should survive it. What his son has done, he needs to forgive him. And I'm hoping that this breakthrough will let them be united as they should, because when you're united, it becomes very difficult to break you. So I'm hoping that as Mr. Martins is also feeling bad for how he treated Baba Gbenro, and now Gbenro is also feeling bad for how he treated his dad, let's see how it's going to bring unity into their family. Yeah, so that's basically it on the Gbenro family. It's a very good family. Hey, if I should go on and on and on, I'm not going to finish, so I'll have to end here. Yeah, so I'll see you in the next episode on Sunday at 11 a.m. GMT on Damilola's YouTube channel at 11 a.m. GMT. I'm in Ghana, so I'll watch it at 11 a.m. If you're in Nigeria, it has to be at 12 a.m. since you are plus one ahead of the GMT. So let me know your thoughts on this. What do you think about Baba Gbenro family? Do you like it? Like, let me know your general thoughts on this, and I'm going to respond to every comment. Every comment. I'm there for today. My name is Lydia once again. Don't forget to like. Don't forget to comment. Don't forget to share. Don't forget to subscribe. Till next time. Bye.